Greetings. I'm a dragon alchemist, and allow me to entertain you. I am once again playing XCOM 2, where we kind of blew up a few supplies, but the mission went very, very smoothly. No one got hurt. And that's what really matters. Ooh, intel. Yeah. Intel's kind of a resource where you really can't speed things up. But before I do that, I'm going to finish building this radio relay, get these increased supplies, and then head for the intel. You really can't get more intel.
These findings will likely prove crucial to our ongoing efforts, Commander.
Let's see what we have.
Central claims to have seen one of these things up close back in the day. Despite a lot of speculation, there was no pilot to be found once we pried it open.
So, fully autonomous. And we can now get the Gremlin Mark III! Guess what I'm going to be spending my supplies on? Let's get the rat.
As initially speculated by Shen, it does in fact appear that this creature is restricted to the confines of its own hulking environmental suit. Unfortunately for our troops, the suit itself is a powerful physical threat, regardless of the operator's status, as we learned with some astonishment in the field.
Yep. But a pair of close-range plasma gatling blasts tends to shut it down, no matter what. I'm gonna have to keep that ability in mind the next time we run into some heavy trouble, because 26 to 30 damage? Yikes!
The coordinates we discovered encoded on the genetic sample recovered from the Advent Black Site imply we may have only scratched the surface of the alien's infrastructure as it relates to this Avatar project. We were fortunate to recover the genetic sample when we did. Otherwise, our path may have very well ended here.
Now, we have a lot of speculation, but we just have to keep investigating. Now, the Gremlin Mark III. 75 supplies. I won't be able to build the armor, but I'm going to be getting supplies soon enough. And I'd rather get my hacking in rather than depend on my armor taking blasts. So, hopefully...
All those people. Millions of innocent lives unknowingly walking right into the aliens' trap. We should have realized sooner. We knew the aliens couldn't be trusted. But their message has always been louder than ours. And they've certainly got a lot more incentives to offer in the city centers than we do out here. Either way, we can't let this go on, no matter what the cost.
Yeah, to continue on what I was saying, hopefully Otacon and Jack can continue making progress in their hacking without failing.
Long live the resistance.
Go! Supplies and proving ground projects have been reduced by 50%, which I will be taking advantage of immediately. So, let's go for 2 war suits.
We'll get started right away, Commander. I'll send word when the project is complete.
And 1 Wraith suit. We will also be putting in an order for battlefield medicine. And that should be all for now. Because it's going to take 20 days and I cannot change the quarry. The queue. Which is rather unfortunate. I really wish I could change the queue, but... well. Now, as I was saying, we need intel.
Avenger,
desperately need
new
intel.
Course.
I know, I still have a lot of it, but it's going to be spent really quickly as we keep making more contacts. I think I've gotten all the supplies I need in our next drop.
Incoming message for you, Commander. Patching it through to your quarters now.
Your progress against the aliens over the past month has been significant, Commander. But there is still room to improve if we are going to eliminate the alien threat.
Is that a shot at the Avatar progress not budging? It's a shot at that, isn't it? We're working on that. We are working towards that facility. Okay, I don't care about retaliation. The armor is slightly annoying. Poison in their weaponry. Ooh, nasty. I may have to be putting that as priority target. And there are my supplies. One short of 500. That's gonna annoy some people with OCD.
Scilab, now operational.
And we get a Scilab. Most excellent. Right, here we go. First things first, engineer to staff it to reduce training times. Secondly, I'm going to be putting myself into the Scilabs. Here we go. Now this is going to take how long? No. How long is this going to take? Back up. 5 days. I'm not quite sure what I'm going to be getting first, but at least I'll get the training in. Intel's going to be probably finished before I finish training.
I am sure you will find the results to be as intriguing as I do, Commander.
And apparently the autopsy is going to get in before the intel does.
The fact that this armored environmental suit is capable of functioning in combat well after the original wearer has expired is remarkable. I must consult with Shin for further study into this unusual behavior.
Proximity mines! I can play around with that. Now, am I going to have the resources for it? We'll find out soon enough once I get the supply cache.
I foresee a number of valuable applications stemming from this technology. I'll have a report assembled as soon as the research is complete.
More intel. Yes, I'm on a bit of an intel binge here. First warsuit has become available. Grants the shield wall technology and experimental powered weapons. Very nice.
Strategic resource located.
40 more intel, not bad. And we have our supply drop. Let's pop over the black market first, see what we can pick up. Always check in with the black market every month. You never know what they have in store. I'm always looking out for more of those perception PCSs. Those are rare. So, not selling the alloys. I will give them a single Archon corpse. Not selling the superior hair trigger, though. So, not much in terms of supplies, but I wasn't here to sell supplies. Superior agility. Well, I'm gonna be binging on my intel supply here, so I'm gonna buy the scope, the expended mag. I don't know about the agility, however. That's for dodge, and as stated before, I'd rather not give my enemies a shot at all. So I'll have to give that a pass. If that was an aim module, however, I would have been on that like a hungry dog on a bone. Advanced Warfare Center? Oh yeah, I don't need anyone to do any retraining. That's perfectly fine. And PsyOps is gonna be done in a day. Alright, let's pick up those supplies while they're there. And then we're gonna be making contact with East Asia.
Avenger plotting new course.
Finally blow up that intel facility. Where are you going? You're taking the long way around. Bradford, I know you said you were a bad pilot. Well, not a great pilot, but this is terrible. Your navigation skills need some brushing up. I have Inspire. We shall continue training.
Depending on who you ask, psionics could be considered the alien's greatest strength. Now our own Psy operatives can tap into that same power.
Goody goody. So, guaranteed psionic damage, make them go insane, or permanently mind control something. What do you think? Permanent mind control? Yes, please! It's gonna take 9 days, but once that kicks in, that's gonna be exceptionally dangerous. Now, what am I gonna give myself here? Couldn't give myself more speed, but let's focus on the weapon upgrades. I don't really know what to get myself, really. I'm mostly going to be relying on my psionics here. I'm not going to use the scope on this, because I'm going to give that to my snipers. Or my heavies. Either or. I think I'll just put things on hold, really. Because I mainly want the repeater. And, well, I suppose the hair trigger's decent. So we'll put that on for now. We'll see who comes into the next mission before I put in the upgrade. We shall continue gathering supplies. And supplies have come in. We do not need more staff. Well, we might need more staff. We might. But not right now. We need to make contact. Blow up this facility, because it's been sitting here way too long.
We've utilized all of our available communications capacity. We can't establish any new contacts until we upgrade our systems.
Okay, yeah, about that. We'll be upgrading one of our resistance comms immediately, because I'm not going to be spending anything else until that happens. So this was going to happen regardless of anything else.
Resistance communications facility upgraded.
And we still have extra power. Let's check what we could upgrade, though. That's
Commander?
One thing I really should check on. So yeah, I can upgrade the comms, I can upgrade the power relays just in case. The defense matrix. Well, if things go bad, I may as well.
Defense facility upgraded.
I have no idea how much time is going to be available until we get hit with one of those defense missions, so it's best to have that in now while I have the supplies to spare. I will also be... I
what
keep
can I do
going
for
to
you,
the
Commander?
Armory. You would think you would go to the armory to build more stuff. We're finally going to get this Warden armor in. Unless... what's the continent bonus? I really should check on the continent bonus. Suit up. All armor and vest proving ground projects are completed instantly. Well, that would have been great to know earlier. Lock and load. Personal combat and weapons can be done. All to intel rewards. I should have gone to Europe first. Too late now. Way too late. Right, let's keep making contact, though.
Attempting to establish local regional contact.
That's the second war suit in. Now we just need the Wraith suit.
The outcome of this research can only further our advances, Commander.
Thank you.
Greetings, Commander.
We have nothing else to research. What about in the Shadow
Chamber? I've seen members of the crew quietly glancing at the scar on my neck. If I wasn't forced to remove the chip myself, the incisions might have been cleaner.
We got nothing else to research, so the labs are going to be going silent for a while. Which is fine. Oh, here we go. We got targets. Okay. Where's that Viper round ammo? It is in New Mexico. I'm going to be getting another scientist, which is rather unfortunate because I don't really have anything else to research. Oh. Enemy unknown. It's going to be interesting. There's something else out there I have not yet seen. Okay, we have an Andromedon, but mostly an Amuton, a Heavy Mech, Elite Shieldbearer, so I'm going to be facing a mix.
Setting course for the Mexican Regional Track.
I don't have to rely entirely on EMP-type stuff. Okay, I'm not going to be sending myself out into the field just yet. I need that domination thing, because Inspire is kind of subpar when we have two colonel-level medics on the field. Until I get domination, I'm putting myself in reserves. So, Maki was on last mission, Otacon was on last mission, Animal was on last mission, and Kelly was on last mission. So, we are putting David in, we are putting Simon in, we are putting Rebecca in, and we are putting Jack in. I think I can leave the exosuits on the other team. Really? Now that I have the war suits. No doubt.
We're calling this heavy power armor the war suit. This is as tough and strong as we can make it, with plenty of power for handling heavy weapons.
Yep, she's gonna like handling that weapon. So, grenades and utilities. No, I still have to do the whole armor and items business. The whole song and dance. So, we're editing. Weapon upgrades. Expanded mags and scope. Let's see about superior expanded mags. Not installing the scope yet. Right. Don't have the Wraith suit yet, so you're gonna just getting to the spider suit for the time being. And the usual Venom rounds. But for weapon upgrades, scope. I think I'm going to leave. Yeah. I'm going to upgrade your scope, because Maku already has the PCS for increased aim, so you need something to bump yourself up. So, you and Maku are technically going to be on equal footing. Still need something for the expanded mags for your sniper rifle, unfortunately, but that will have to wait. That does leave Simon with the other war suit. Still has a rocket launcher. And for your utility item. Oh, right. I had almost forgotten. Build items. We're gonna build that Warden armor, finally.
This is our basic power armor frame, providing the durability you'd expect from a giant armored suit.
You look like Samus Aran in that armor. I have to admit that. Coloration's not quite right, but the plating does look oddly familiar. Do I want to buy the beam pistol? Not necessarily. I do want the proxy mine, though. That's gonna cost 100 supplies! Wow. But the ability to just ambush my opponents? Yeah, that's going in, no matter what. So, loadout will consist of the rounds, the blue screen rounds, but who's gonna toss the proxy mine? Because I want that grenade launcher for starting things off. I suppose Hijack is going to be getting the proxy mine again. He's generally gonna be rushing ahead to use that Skulljack, so if he's gonna be that close, that proxy mine's gonna be very effective. Definitely not putting the medics up front. No way. I think I've covered about. Oh, right. Almost forgot the kicker. Flashbangs. Can't forget the flashbangs. Alright, everyone's armored up. We have the upgraded gremlins. This should be rather decent.
Deploy.
Menace, ready to deploy.
Operation Hammer Wheel. Sounds like an industrial equipment piece.
Dr. Tigan has picked up a signal from a hidden alien vent network from
this
area.
Giant frame.
Anything we can do to disrupt the aliens' logistics increases our chances of stopping their progress. We'll need to secure the area and eliminate any hostiles, then destroy the relay before they finish their transmission.
Well, I suppose the only hammers that are going to be here are going to be smashing that relay. Hop in. Leave no survivor. It's not like we really could get survivors. We don't have that stun weapon.
They call it the communications relay is up ahead. Move in and destroy the target.
Position is
that
required.
Stun. What is it called? Oh well, it was the first XCOM. I've completely forgotten it. Shoddy memories. Okay, this has. It has cover. It has decent range, I hope. Grapple up. Make use of that free move and all. Oh, okay. Well, I happen to know what's going to be going first. David, you're moving over here. And just in case they try anything, you are going into Overwatch's position next in a moment. I have to see about cover. There's no really great cover around here. No, there is not. I know I want Rebecca somewhere up ahead. I need her to launch that plasma grenade. Fortunately, it's a dash over here, but I don't think I have much choice. So yeah, dash over here. All of my supports are going up top. Mainly because they have that aid protocol ability, so that turns that half cover to full cover. Seeing as the only mechanical target is going to be that Andromedon, once it's dead, Jack's not going to be wholly critical to this operation here. Where to put him, really? I guess I could put him right here.
On it.
It's going to put him a little close to the target, but I doubt they're going to survive a full volley. So we're going on Overwatch. Simon is going to be my usual scout, so I'm not going to be moving him up too far. He's going to go over here, and only if things get very, very complicated am I getting him out of concealment. We will be attempting the cheap tactics again. Okay, they're not moving very far. All right, David. You are putting kill zone on these targets.
Look at that.
Tim, you know the drill. A protocol on yourself. Doc, a protocol on yourself. Hi, Jack. Let's see, a protocol on yourself. Well, actually, it might be better to give Rebecca the aid protocol, as she can shred multiple targets after she does the grenade. Unfortunately for me, I think they've gone just out of range of the plasma grenade. What about the rocket launcher? I can still hit, but she's not going to get much line of sight on any targets. No, she's not. If I move her here, she has no target, so I must move her up. Fortunately, she's only going to have half cover, but that's where the aid protocol comes in. Now, Jack's not going to get his own turn to Overwatch here, unfortunately. So I simply have to put him on standard Overwatch.
Surprise.
Everything is set. Plasma grenade or rocket launcher? The rocket launcher has smaller radius, and they're all grouped up. So I may as well blow them all up here. I also want to leave them no full cover. But that full cover is not really facing them because of that rock, so that's perfectly fine. No. If I blow up the rocks, then they do have full cover. So, blow it all
Boom.
Up. Leave nothing standing. Shredded, damaged, and completely vulnerable. Yep, start moving. It's not gonna end pretty. Oops, so this. Yutan is as well. And David should still have his killzone ability up. Okay, that was somewhat awkward. Now, unfortunately, that does leave the Andromedon standing. I still have my two supports, however. So, we will be rapid-firing this into oblivion. That, still standing. Still standing. We can't be having that. Ah, darn it. Sean doesn't have angle. So he's going to standard Overwatch, while Simon's going to stay put.
I'm on it.
David's kill zone should still be active, however. Move and die. Oh, never mind. Sean actually does the target.
Das war's für dich.
They couldn't get a single square out of position before getting blasted. Just the way I like it. Now, unfortunately, I am on a timer here, so I can't afford to sit.
Ready to go!
That said, however, that doesn't mean I can't blow a hole through the wall and let my hackers deal with it from there. Simon's gonna be moving up. Forward scout. Do we have anything?
We've got an enemy squad here.
Oh yeah, we got something, alright. Three armored targets. That's going to be rough. That said, however, we do have Jackie here, and he does have his improved gremlin for once. Alright. We have a good position, we can lure them in. We do have six turns, and if need be, as said, I can just blow up the walls. All right, David, you have a single shot, a single target. Is it going to be enough to kill? It will not. That armor is going to come in the way. But if I deadeye it, it's 85%, but it can outright kill him. I don't want the shield bearer to do anything of his actual nature. Yep, shield bearer is terminated. He was out in the open. He had no chance. Death from above. Let's reload. Unless I actually get the plasma pistol, going on pistol overwatch isn't that great. However, the mechs are now aware that we're here in a somewhat limited manner. Which is why we will have Rebecca. No, she's not going to be able to plasma grenade that target. So she's going to move up slightly more. Yep, that activated them. That's fine. You know why? Plasma! Ah, it's still not enough. Just not enough to blow up the wall. Oh well.
Explosion!
Shred both targets, please. Overwatch has been removed, but it's not like I was going to do anything
Objective
about
located.
That. Anyways. Okay. Haywire or combat? Ooh, 10 to 11. I can kill one of them outright. How much pips is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So I got a 50-50 shot of terminating this mech. I may as well take that chance. If this doesn't work, I'm just gonna have Simon do his business. Nope. That mech's done for. Okay, we're going on Overwatch with Sean. And we'll see what happens. What? Ah, that's a miss. What about you, Tip? That's a hit. Unfortunately, that's not enough.
Deflection!
What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? Ah, no. You're fine. You're all fine. That's minor damage. Or, unless you fall down. Alright, I have to do something about this right now because it's looking a little nasty. I could use restoration. That is a possibility. Yeah, you know what? Tim, you're gonna go over here.
Sure thing.
And you're going to restore. Well, do I want to restore? Then again, it's not like I got anything else to do and I gotta save my moves. Well, let's try combat protocol again, shall we? No, I want Jack to move up, actually. I need him to start hacking. So, Rebecca, no, that's overkill. That's just plain overkill. So, Sean, you're gonna be the one taking the kill here. Unless someone else gets a promotion. Actually, wait, is David a colonel yet? No, he's not a colonel yet. So, you're getting the kill. Oh, I can still grapple somewhere? Yeah, that's kind of risky. You're staying put and you're firing. That's 100% hit.
Solo il meglio. È quel che stavamo cercando.
Oh, right. That's gonna be annoying. That is going to be very annoying. Oh good, the noise stopped. Alright, start getting the heals in, please. Start healing yourselves. I don't want my medics to go down before they can heal anybody else. Fortunately, David took a bit of a beating there, somehow. We are not moving up quite yet. Not without Simon doing the usual scouting business.
Moving to designated position.
Yeah, there's nothing out here. Okay, go up all the way.
There now.
Anybody inside the building? No. Alright. I think I can afford to move Jack out into the open.
No need to ask twice.
We have to get to the target. There's no way around it. Ooh, superior stuff and a data pad. That's a decent haul.
I have the asset.
Okay, let's move Rebecca up. I need her to have line of sight on this target. Yeah, she's gonna have to go over here. She's got the heavy weapon. She's the one who can shred this thing. Well, not shred, just plain out destroy. Okay, David, you're in a bit of a compromised position here, so you are heading this way.
Come now.
You're gonna need a lot of healing, though. Reload.
We are
moving Tim up just a tad.
Hitting out.
There we go, full cover. And heal for David.
Gremlin, medical detail.
As for David, no, as for Shaw.
Ich rück aus.
Gonna get cover from two positions. And really just overwatch in case we get surprises. I'd rather not have more surprises. Can Rebecca get target from here? No, let's rush her up. Let's rush her up.
Allez, on bouge!
If Simon can't see anything, then we're fine as is. We are going to be moving Simon around to over here to check the left side for any targets. left side's clear, he will stay put.
Affirmative, covering now.
We can afford to let the enemy come to us now.
Stepping off.
There should be enough firepower to destroy the transfer device.
The alien transmission is still active and we're running out of time. Get to the relay and take it out, ASAP.
That's what Rebecca and Hijack are for. They're not gonna get there any faster. I really hate to do this, but I do have to move David up.
D'accordo.
This is way too out of squad sight range, and he has no elevated position anymore, so there's no 20% increase. Move him up, move him up. Once we destroy this thing, the enemies are going to be rushing us.
Position bestätigt.
Alright, let's blow this thing up right now. Actually, I can afford to hold off. I do have two turns. Or Rebecca just blows it up outright. Never mind.
Menace 1-5, we've confirmed destruction of the relay. The alien transmission is down. Eliminate any remaining hostiles and move to evac.
Alright, Hijack. You are going on Overwatch.
On Overwatch!
Same with you, Simon.
Got it
covered. We are letting them come to us. There they are. Okay, that's
the unknown.
This one
is uniquely graceful compared to some of the other species we've seen. It also kicks off very strong psionic.
Oh, that thing is very heavily armored.
Get the armor.
Yeah, Simon, we do not need you to be in concealment anymore. We have gone past the point of concealment a long time ago. Flashbang. I can't flashbang this target, though. I might consider that. That's a lot of armor, though. That's the thing. I don't really have great targeting here. I could throw this proxy mine. No, I don't have great angle here. I have to remove this wall. I have to remove this wall. Okay, I'm going to move Sean. Okay, you will have target over here. I'd rather put you in full cover, but there's none really here.
Verstanden, bin unterwegs.
I think you are just going to stay put and hollow beacon. Still need to remove these walls, though. These walls are going to become an issue. So yeah, Simon, I need you to send a rocket in there. Get rid of the walls, amongst other things. It's gonna be a tricky shot though, that's the thing. I may have to just outright reveal you. I may have to do just that. It's not gonna be pretty. Oh, no. Well, maybe. No, I have to reveal you. I have to get a cleaner shot with this rocket.
Affirmative, moving out.
Yeah, kind of a waste of concealment, but... Oh, wait, that didn't ruin your concealment. Huh. Interesting. But that's not the point. The point is, I want this rocket right here. There we are, that's the money shot. Armor shredded, targets exposed, we have a killing field.
Position compromised.
Ooh. Tim does have a grenade. Let's move him up.
Not a problem.
Let's just pitch more grenades in. Pitch them all in. This target's way too armored for my liking. And not enough radius to hit both the mutons, so I'll take one again. Okay, that's still 60% on the gatekeeper. I may as well shred the target and hollow target in as well, if she hits. miss. That's a miss. Hollow targeting is established, however. Who still has turn? That's Simon and Hijack and David. David only has line of sight on the gatekeeper. You missed. I think I may have to throw that hollow beacon. Right? Yeah, I may have to throw that hollow beacon. Kill the muton. I need one less variable in my life.
Hostile target down.
That just leaves this thing. I do not know how to describe it besides a floating sphere. So, throw it right here. Why aren't you throwing? Bro. Come on. Bro! There we go. Yes, be distracted. Be very distracted. Oh, come on! It moves into out of line of sight of everyone else. Oh well. Do I have line of sight here? No, I do not. Not over here. I will not. So, from the looks of things, I'm just gonna have to storm the building. Not a nice prospect, but I don't see any other way to do this. Notice I throw this proxy mine. Will this proxy mine trigger on this thing immediately is the question. Wow, that has a giant explosive radius. Yeah, I'm not going to be throwing it. Not right now. I do want to get Rebecca the kill, though. That's the thing. So we're going to do combat protocol on it because, hey, confirm damage. I'm not going to pass that away. Okay, that should be enough for Rebecca to kill it. Nope, not enough. Just not enough. Let's do what's the hack here first.
This is Mian.
I may as well check it out. I highly doubt I'm not going to kill this thing this turn. I have way too many people ready to do it. Distraction. Oh yeah. We have options. We don't have to worry about this. I can just run Rebecca in there. She can tear the thing apart. And we can call it a day. 65%? Yeah. Doesn't matter. We have a second shot. And then I'm going to do the hack. Where's the... go. I know, it's wasting all the other turns that I could potentially get, but I just want Rebecca to get the hack. Thank you, improved gremlins, because my luck still utterly is garbage.
Wir sind durch.
Extra action. So, Rebecca, finish him off. I mean, you got 4 and 5% chance to hit. So, if you miss, no hard feelings, but I'd really prefer you to get the kill. Oh, this thing explodes!
J'ai tué un ennemi là! Mon arme est à sec!
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure.
Okay, I'll have to keep that in mind for the next time I see one of those things. They explode when they die. Alright, sorry about this, people. Some of you are gonna spend a few days in medbay. It was a learning experience, however, that was a new enemy. Still didn't get any promotions, though. That's a shame. But the warden armor worked out very well. Kept you all alive. I hate those mechs with their grenades. It's bloody, bloody grenades. Well, at least that operation went off without anyone getting killed. Not as flawless as my last mission, but that was a timed mission. I couldn't afford to just sit back and let my snipers do their job. Alright, who's gravely wounded? Alright. Well, David actually got wounded for once. Surprise! The snipers usually come out completely unscathed. Let's just hope that he's not shaken. Yep. Gatekeeper. Yeah, we're gonna do an autopsy on you right away.
Hello, Commander.
Scientists. And... okay, David's not shaken. Commander. That's all I really could ask for. So, two things to research. Let's get this gatekeeper.
Henceforth referred to as the Gatekeeper, seems to harbor considerable psionic power. As with the alien's other unique biomechanical field unit, it will take some time to decipher the systems involved in its function.
It's basically a giant brain inside a shell.
The aliens have considerable resources at their disposal, but we've still managed to do reasonably well against them, despite our own limitations.
I may as well install a lab over here when I have spare resources. I mean, when I have resources, I just can't spend anywhere else. But for now, I think I'm going to put an end to this episode.
I don't like the fact that we're chasing another set of coordinates into the middle of nowhere. We've done it before, and we didn't like what we found then either. Wilderness or not, the aliens could be setting up an ambush, or worse for all we know. Our people will be prepped and ready for a fight. I just wish we had more to go on.
Yeah, same here. Unfortunately, both my medics are in the med bay for a bit, so I'm not even gonna go there until they're back online. But that will be for another episode, and it might not even be the next one. Until then, however, I hope I have entertained you.